Grace and peace to you from God, our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Hello, I'm JC, Director of Stronghold Cambodia. I'm so thankful for the opportunity today to speak to you. His reason indeed. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you so much for dying on the cross for our sins. But you did not die forever. You arose from the dead. Because of your resurrection, we continue to be able to place our trust and hope in you. Lord, may you continue to help us that we are able to spread this good news to the people around us. Again, be with us today as we share the joy of resurrection with one another. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Our scripture today is taken from Luke chapter 24, verse 6 and 7. I shall read, "He is not here. He has risen. Remember how he told you while he was still with you in Galilee. The Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of the sinful man, be crucified, and on the third day be raised again." In Cambodia, this time of the year is the season of tomb clearing. The extended family from far and near get together to visit the tomb of their dead, relative to clean the tomb, to offer food, and to show the respect. There was a similar event 2,000 years ago in Jerusalem. A group of women went to the tomb. They walked into the tomb and went straight to look for the body of Jesus, but the body was not there. They could not find their dead. The scripture tells us they were wondering about this. Missing the body of Jesus perplexed and confused the woman. They did not know what to do, what to think, or which way to turn to. While they were wondering about this, two angels appeared to them and started a conversation by asking them questions. "Why do you look for the living among the dead? Where do you look for the dead?" "You look for the dead in the graveyards or funeral homes." "Where do you look for the living?" "You don't look for them in the tomb. You look for the living in the place of the living. You look for the dead in the place of the dead. But you don't look for the living in the place of the dead." And now it's another question. Why were the women doing this? According to the gospel that we just read, "He is not here, he has risen." The women forgot the words of Jesus. They forgot the promises of God in the Old Testament. How many times did Jesus tell his follower he was going to die, but on the third day be raised? At least 3 times. But they failed to remember, so they become so afraid, discouraged, and disappointed because they did not remember what Jesus has told them. We sometimes, just like the women and the disciples, we fail to remember who Jesus is. We fail to remember Jesus' promise. We fail to remember the cross. We fail to remember the empty grave because we are just more like the woman and his disciple. Sadly, Cambodia is in the midst of the third severe COVID-19 community outbreak. It has affected people's livelihood. So far, 10 people have died. Not enough rooms for the positive cases patients. Schools are instructed to close. Economy is down. And travel restriction is imposed. Brother and sister in Christ, either in Cambodia or in the US, many of us have become the victim of COVID-19 in some ways. Losing family members, living separate from each other, children could not get proper schooling, losing employment. When life gets turned upside down, we are worried, depressed, and heartbroken. No hope. Because of your sin and mine, 2,000 years ago, Jesus was crucified, died, and was buried. But on the third day, he rose again from the dead. He defeated death. He has victory over the death. Today, as we celebrate his resurrection, let us rejoice and continue to place our trust and hope in him alone, in spite of current circumstances, because we know for sure that we are serving a risen Savior who has things under his control. My friend, remember that Christ has risen from the dead. His victory is our victory. Remember who he is. Remember what he's doing in you. Remember that he, the risen Lord, is working in you and with you. Remember, we serve a risen Savior. Don't ever forget that Jesus lives. Because he lives, we will fear no tomorrow. We will have no fear for tomorrow. The peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and mind in Christ Jesus. Amen.